we do have a raffle, yes, we have a raffle. Few little prizes on the front table there, just for club funds. The weather's with us, the water's clear. Enjoy yourself. Any problems, come and see one of the committee, myself, or anyone else, and have a good day. And we'll announce when we're going to be doing the boat snooker.
Thank you.
prize, it goes to Bernard. Bernard Lee Nye, 40 points. Where's Bernard? You got a present coming. Well done, Bernard. Okay, second was Edwin. Well done, Edwin. With a score of 37, actually, which is very commendable. And third was John Boyd, with a score of 34. Okay, and then we got Adam on fourth. Well done, Adam. We've got Andy Cheeseman on fifth. Then we've got a joint six with Neil Terry and Paul Goodman. And we've got a seventh place with Kelvin. And we've got four on 23 points. That's Dave, Chris, Dennis, and Len. And four men there with 23 points each, which makes them joint eighth. And last was Mr. Sadler. Well done, everybody. We'll do it again later on this afternoon if everyone wants to have another go at it. So back to free sailing, and it looks like have we got any hovercraft running now? Okay. Neil's going to put the hovercraft out, and then free sailing for the rest of the day. Very interesting. On the far side there, you've got the steamboat over there from Ian. That's a flash steam engine controlled by his own electronics or radio. He made his own computer for it. I think he'll bring it down this side of the lake. Let's all have a look, or the spectators have a look down this side. Yeah, it's an extremely beautiful boat built, and the engineering is excellent. Ian can also control this by voice command. We can actually just speak to it, and it will actually work stuff out and by a code and move that right. A flash steam engine, which means it makes its own steam. It doesn't need a boiler, it just uses the steam that's produced. Therefore, we don't need a boiler certificate to run it here. So, if we feel it demands a boiler certificate, we'll have to have a boiler on it. If it hasn't got one, that's just by the rules. Looks very majestic. And again, if you can ever come around and have a look at it sometime, it would work on it. It's actually superb. It's done with mahogany. Well done, Ian, and thanks for bringing it down to the show. What else we got out there? We've got three hovercraft here, of course. Neil Terry and the builder, Dave, standing by. Very interesting little craft. First time we've had hovercraft in the Whitney Club. Obviously, there's been hovercraft down here, but not to be hovercraft. And we've got three of them here. Just about to demonstrate the SRN 6. The other one's better. Here she goes, right across the water. Controlled by Dave. Dave has built this. Is this a Griffin? Going through the course is Derek Rudge's single man canoe, another ingenious piece of work, all mechanically controlled, works very, very well. Derek's had this for over a year now, and he's perfected it now. It looks very realistic, a lovely model. What else have we got out there? Quite a few sights, of course. Thank you.
Don't chuck it before switching it on like I did.
Thank you. You must have a bigger garage than I've got.
Yeah, I've got a big workshop. Yeah. I've got a QE2 at 12 foot. Which will probably be this time next year. No, I think it's second hand. Yeah.
Passive income up very often,
isn't it? No, it's Blake in Scotland. And it got the QE2, which was in three sections, and that was in two sections. And I said, how much for the lot? Both of them. Over the phone. And he said, £1,500. So I said, yeah, I love that. I can pick that up.
That's
all aluminium. The only bit that's wood in it is the bulkheads. We bolt it together. But it didn't work. I had it at Tommy's Wells at the Norman Lake. It worked perfect. Yeah, all working. Mm-hmm. So I fitted the smokers in it for this weekend. So it's all got smoke coming out. Put it on the water.
It's not possible.
I know. I put it on the water. I had quite a few people saying, oh, I've been looking forward to this going out. And there were people charging about €20 and trying to get the soapers, which is not easy because funny things doing this. And then we got it and I'm going,
yes. It was
doing really well. And it's on 40 megs. So, one of the lads here is going to take it home and he's going to convert it to a German.
I mean, if you look at this, and that's
Neil to work. Phil Neil. Yeah, he's going to do it for me. He's a really good subject.
There he is.
No, he can't be off.
Yeah, he's the man.
What's your username on YouTube?
Retsub.
I've looked at some of your
Retsub
videos.
Retsub12, which is my dog was Buster. No, I just needed a name. Well, Retsub is Buster backwards.
I've looked at some of your videos. Yeah. I was looking through some last night from Guernsey Abbey.
We seem to be getting more and more people look at them now. We get comments from Australia, America. China.
Yeah. Yeah. They're only asking to take them down.
Yeah.
Where's the porn?
Where's the porn? Yeah.
Well, I put a bit on one of them. I did. Yeah. Big models.
Yeah.
Big models.
All of a sudden, it got loads of it.
You think titties?
Why does this one get more hits than one I spend a lot of time on? Yeah, and it suddenly dawned on me, big
model.
Someone's
thinking models, titties.
They're yours, Phil.
What?
Yeah.
They put in Randy Boats next time or something. Naked yachts.
Now that I'd look at.
Yeah, I'd look at that.
Type in Chinese prawns.
naked yachts you would look at?
Oh yeah.
A boat with just a mast.
Yeah.
Whatever rocks your boat.
The racing's a bit boring though.
Can I add your picture to that boat?
Yeah.
Don't get no money.
Take the camera quick.
Yeah,
you
might need a bit of
a
filter.
I'll take them on. Oh, Mark,
put them back.
Oh, no, you look better with them on. Oh, right. Look, have you noticed? Look.
Yeah, you're better off without them.
He's got a good editing suite.
Like I was using the plastic kit one.
Yeah.
It
looks as dirty as
when
I remember.
Well, apparently that's modelled as it went to Turkey to be.
They phoned us up on Monday and said they'd like to offer him the job. So he's off to Wales for a year.
But they look more like eyes in those days, don't they?
So he's gone.
Thanks very much, Pete.
Dad, it's about 45 and she's big 70s.
I reckon it'll be about And then if you've got time after the raffle, I'll do another boat snooker. And that should take us around to about 4 o'clockish. So if you get all your tickets there, we'll get sorted out for the raffle.
Number 1, 4, 14. big one over there is the winner. Look, then, that big one's won.
Number 55.
Cool, eh?
335. 335.
Wow.
Oh, look at that yellow one.
Right, last of these, number 118.
You. Jason.
Thank you very much, everybody. Thank you. this time it'll be a pink. Here we go. Brayne is in 4 points. There we go, we're lining up for the Brayne. Yeah, no problem there, that's a brown. Back for the red, please. Just over a minute left, we've got. Yep, that's another red, and this time it's a black. Have another go at the black. 7 points if you get there. There we go, keep an eye on him. Yeah, he's done it that time. Well done, that's a black. Okay. Back to the red then, but you've only got 4 seconds. And that's it. Well, yeah, okay, I'll get the one for you. Well done. Well done, Devin. Okay, we've got Andy now. Andy, are you ready? Okay then, you know the score. Through the red and it'll be all a black straight away for you. Andy's got 6 dice. Not as fast as the mid-bar, obviously. Time starts when you go through it. Andy and Black. Yellow. There we go.